Welcome to Atlanta Sightseeing. Please take your seat and keep your hands and feet inside the railing at all times.
And we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming, and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Welcome to Atlanta where the players play, and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming, and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Hello, Domination, and welcome back to the wonderful channel of Mistress Aurora. Thank you for returning, and if you are new, please subscribe to this channel. However, thanks for watching. Today on Word of the Week, we are going to go over branding. It's going to be very short. If you did not know already, branding is a part of BDSM. Now, I didn't know this, especially going to an HBCU where, you know, everyone that pledges, or not everyone, but a lot of the men that pledge get branded, especially Q's. That's a thing for them. However, alphas get branded too. Did not know that. I think sigmas and iotas also get branded, just not as much. Maybe not in this southern region. They might do it in other parts wherever they're more popular. However, I don't know if kappas do it though. Don't know. Anyway, we are talking about branding. Now, to me, that means that's a permanent solution. That is something that a dom and a sub would probably do if they're a couple. However, if you have very, very loyal subs that want your mark on them, branding is a way to go. Would I do branding? I don't think I'm opposed to it. Yeah, I know a lot of people who have been branded. I think, however, if you are a dom or a sub and you want to brand or be branded, you need to do your research. You need to get like professional training on how to do this. You don't just need to throw an iron in the fire and stick it on somebody's skin, because you could pull their skin off. That is not branding. That is something different. They may have to go to the hospital for that, and they probably will. So that's a risk you could take branding someone. Also, you are damaging all the nerves in that part of their skin when you do it, so you need to be careful where you put it. So if you are interested in branding or being branded, do your research. Go talk to someone. I mean, it's not like the craziest thing that could happen to you, so it's okay. Like I said, I know people personally that have been branded, that have done it through, you know, fraternities, and they're fine. But you also run the risk of, you know, certain scarring and possibly keloids if you're a person of color, and then just, you know, things like that. It's things that you really, really want to look into before you're just like, oh shit, this is part of BDSM, let's do that. So comment below if you are a sub or a dom and you're branded. Tell me what that experience is like. How is it getting your flesh burned? Like, that's not scary. I don't know. I've always thought it was interesting. And brands look pretty cool to me personally. I think they're cool. Comment below if you want to be branded and give me your reasons on why. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you don't like it, fuck it. Whatever, don't care. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. Make sure you hit that bell so you know when I'm dropping another video. Follow me on all my social media and check out the description below for more and more and more. All my links gives you the links to all my sites, my Amazon gift wish list, I gotta stop calling it a gift list, or well, maybe not. Anyway, Amazon wish list is there, and the definition is also down there. There also will be links to different ways of branding and how you can go about that procedure if you're interested in it. I'm not telling you to do it though. So this is me opting out of saying, oh, you should do it. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is, if you're interested, here's some information. Learn, research, be safe, And I'll see y'all next week on Word of the Week. Bye.